नमस्ते, आई एम डॉक्टर सुरेश। वेलकम टू द चैनल टीचर एजुकेशन सिंप्लीफाइड। दिस वीडियो इज़ अबाउट सेकेंड ईयर बीएड ऑफ सावित्रीबाई फुले पुणे यूनिवर्सिटी। दिस वीडियो विल गिव यू द फीचर्स ऑफ द कोर्स। आई विल एडवाइस यू टू विजिट द सावित्रीबाई फुले पुणे यूनिवर्सिटी वेबसाइट एंड सी द ओरिजिनल करिकुलम ऑफ सेकेंड ईयर बीएड। दिस वीडियो इज द सेकेंड पार्ट। In first part, I have explained about the first year of B.Ed of Savitribai Phule Pune University. So, if you have seen the first year B.Ed video, this video will be helping you to understand the second year B.Ed course. So, let us see. These are the features of overall B.Ed course. Duration is of 2 years. The current syllabus has been implementing from 2015 and 16. Exam pattern is yearly. Total credits for this course are 80. You must know the credits of the curriculum because when you go internationally, you are asked to share the credits of the course. So these are the credits. 80 credits are for this whole 2 years B.Ed course. Medium of instruction is Marathi or English, and the medium of answer, that is medium of examination, will be Marathi or English. So let us see the second year B.Ed syllabus one by one. So in the second year B.Ed, you will have 5 papers. It will having 500 total marks, and 20 credits are allotted for it. There are practical part having 7 activities for 500 marks, and 20 credits are given. Total 1000 marks are given for second year B.Ed, and total credits are 40. Let us see what are the core courses. We can say compulsory papers. So there are 3 compulsory papers for second year B.Ed. It is called B.Ed 201. 2 means second year. So 201 is quality management, quality and management of the school education. Second is about knowledge and curriculum and language across the curriculum. And third is school and inclusive school. So these 3 courses are compulsory papers for everyone. 4 credits for each, and marks are 80-20, 80 university exam, 20 internal marks having some practicals. So these 3 are compulsory papers. There are 2 optional courses. Remember, optional doesn't mean that you have any option to select or not select. There are options in the specializations. So B.Ed 204 is called elective. So there are a number of subjects given, you will have to select any one of it. B.Ed 205, again it's there are 28 subjects and you will have to select any one. So optional doesn't mean that you have freedom not to select it. Yes, you will have the freedom to select a particular subject from the given list. Again, the pattern is same, 80-20. Now coming back to B.Ed 204 elective, you will have to select any one of it. There are 10 options: guidance and counseling, education for human rights and peace education, women education, lifelong education, population education and family life education, education for sustainable development and environmental education, disaster management, inclusive education, introduction to educational research, water, air and energy education. So select any one out of these 10. So you have freedom to select any one of the subject. So this is about 204. 205 is about the selecting the third method. You remember, you have 2 methods in first year. Now in second year, you will have only 1 method in addition to the method that you have selected for first year. For second year, you will have only 1 method as a paper. So there are 28 options given to you. You'll have to select any one of the method that you have not selected for the first year. You cannot repeat the method. Now these subjects are specially targeted for the junior colleges, like those are not non-schooling subjects, like C, like German, French, Japanese, philosophy, psychology, sociology, and even the physics, chemistry, biology, These subjects are not for the school level, but it is for the junior college level, that is higher secondary level. So when you selecting the topic, you are expected to select the topic related to your graduation and post graduation subjects. If you are from commerce method, from BCom or MCom, then select commerce method. If you are for science, and then select the subject for the specialization of your graduation goes post graduation. Suppose you are from social sciences, then select the topic, select the subject that you can teach on the higher secondary level. So this is you should think about your career opportunities when you are selecting this topic. That method, this third method, should be complementary to your graduation subject and your first two methods. Let us see the second year B.Ed. evaluation pattern for 2001 to 2005. Total marks for each paper is 100, 80-20 pattern. 80 marks for the university paper, which is descriptive and offline. Internal marks will be 20 marks, including practical, tutorial assignments and prelim examinations. Learning load for each paper is 30 clock hours. 16 clock hours expected for classroom interaction and 14 clock hours expected for assignments and self-study. Marks per credit are 25 marks. So each paper, like from 2001 to 2005, will having 4 credits and 100 marks. Apart from theory papers, what are the practicals to be performed? Let us see first. 206 is about teaching competencies, practice lessons, and 207 is internship. Let us see the details of practice lessons and internship. 206 is about practice lessons. So total there are 6 practice lessons in the school. You remember you have 3 methods, 2 from FY, 1 for SY. So 2 lessons each for the methods. Duration of each lesson should be 30 minutes. These lessons should be conducted in the schools. Now coming to 207, internship. This is the major part of the curriculum of second year. 16 weeks in a school. So when you join the internship, you will directly going to the school. You are not coming for the college. You are directly joining the school for the internship, you are working totally for 16 weeks in the school. These are the mandatory activities that should be performed in the internship. There are 6 lessons. Then some plan of evaluation should be prepared. A study of the record maintained by the school. Organization of co-curricular activity or extracurricular activities in the school. Observation of your peers' lessons and other schools' activity and program. So you will have to observe all these activities and you will have to write a report, and it is to be submitted after the completion of the internship program. These are 6 mandatory activities, but apart from that you get lots of work, lots of experiences other than these prescribed activities in the schools. So these are for almost 4 months. After lessons, there are some more activities has been planned in the curriculum for enhancing professional capacities. These are 208, 209, 210, 11 and 12. Remember, these activities don't have theory papers, don't have university exam paper. These are practical to be conducted in the college. Let us see one by one. 208 about reading and reflecting on the text. In this activity, you'll have to select a particular topic and you will have to reflect on it. The assessment, the evaluation will be on the basis of your 2 reports. One is of orientation reports. Your professor in charge or expert will orient you how to read and reflect. And in second part, you will have to actually read and reflect on a particular text. So you are expected to write 2 reports for orientation session and activity session, and marks will be given on the basis of these 2 reports. 209 is about understanding of yourself. It is this practical will help you to understand about yourself as a person, as a teacher. There are many activities given in it. Again, the assessment will be based on your two reports. One is orientation reports and second is activity reports. So there are four activities, minimum four activities should be conducted, like interview, SWOT analysis, etc., etc. So two reports are expected in this activity two. 2010, about the basics of research. You will have to select a particular topic for a research, write a proposal on it, conduct the research actually in the school, and again write a report, research report, and present a report to your professor in charge. So again, this is based on the practical, and you will have to conduct the research and you will have to present the research. And the marks will be given on the basis of your proposal and your research report and presentation. 2011 is about drama and art in the education. This is something, the aesthetic part of the curriculum. There are some activities mentioned in the syllabus about drama and art. Again, the assessment will be done on the basis of two reports. One is of orientation reports and second is of activity sessions report. So all these activity will find two reports are expected, orientation and activity session. Now last part in the curriculum is open course or entrepreneurship development. So again, here choice, either you go for open course or you go for entrepreneurship development. So in the open course, some activities are mentioned based on the life skill in the syllabus. So you'll have to select a particular life skill and you'll have to perform that activity. Again, the assessment will be done on the basis of two reports, orientation reports, activity session reports. Or you can go for the entrepreneurship development activities related to professional associated with the teaching, like e-content development, publication, writing books, etc., etc., and you will have to perform an activity. Assessment will be basis on the orientation session report and the activity session report. From activity 208 to 2012, you will find two reports are expected. The points will be given by the college to you. The points for writing the report of orientation and the points for writing the report for the activity session. For each and every specialized activity, the points will be different. But this point will be provided by the college to you. So these are 12. So this is all about the curriculum, be it 2001 to 2012. Let us see how the evaluation is done. To qualify this degree, you will have 50% in each and every head of passing. From BA 2001 to 2005, internal marks are 20, which are added to the 80 marks of the university examination, and result will be declared calculated out of 100. University exam generally conducted in the month of April, last week of April and first week of May. For BA 2006 to BA 2012, these are internal marks, practical based on your activity, and these marks are converted into the grade. If you find these grading system, depends on your percentage. And final result is combination of first year and second year marks. So your mark list of second year will have combining first year and second year of marks. In your mark sheet of second year, you will find the marks and your grade, what grade you got. So that grade will be mentioned on your mark sheet. This is overall formula of second year mark list. You will find these are the assessment of 2 years, first year 101 to 1012, and how it will be assessed. And for second year 2001 to 2012, so these are the courses. First year is having total 1000 marks and 40 credits, and same for the second year, and total credits are 80. So this is the overall annual pattern. Now some more important points. Acquire some additional qualification to your resume, like certificate courses in education, computer arts, and diploma. So these are very much important when you are joining the school. Your additional assets will be definitely considered. Attend various conferences, present paper, write article during this BA course itself. Try to get the more professional experiences in this course because you are going to be a teacher. Be interactive and develop interpersonal relationship. That is very essential in the teaching profession. Some students are shy, some students are introvert, they do not interact with the students, peer and teachers and professor in charge. So as a teacher, you should be very interactive with all the stakeholders of the education. So you need to develop that particular interpersonal skill during the course. Participate in different co-curricular activities and school and colleges and try to get maximum experiences and gain the confidence. When you are appearing for second year, you can give MAAT, TET, TET exam and CTET exams. So go for it. You can give TAIT exam after completing the BA. That is essential to join junior college and secondary school. In the second year itself, learn to prepare a proper resume and write how to write the job applications. Once your result is declared of second year, do not forget to apply the convocation, that is for degree certificate, because that is required sometimes. Sometimes it is essential, so have it immediately after the declaration of your result. The separate portal for convocation has been given on the Savitribai Phule Pune University's website. Make smart use of the internship for the job search, because there you will be contact with the school supervisors, school teachers and principals of the school. So you will get the opportunity for joining the same school or the other school, but you will get that information during your internship. Start applying from the month of February or March, because generally advertise come for the school from January itself. Especially CBSE school, they want teachers from the month of March or April. So even you are appearing for the second year, you have not qualified the B.Ed, but still you can apply on the basis of appearing for the second year course. If you are thinking about applying in the school after your results, mean in the month of June or July, so until that, most of the vacancy already filled. So better to start applying from the month of February, March itself. So this is all about the second year B.Ed course, and I hope you have seen full video, and thank you very much for watching the whole video. If you liked and if you think it is useful, you can share it with your friends. Thank you very much, and very all the best for your teaching.